Hi, Founder fans. Jason here, and today's founder is Philemon Dickinson. Now, Philemon is a little bit less famous than his extraordinarily important brother, John Dickinson. And John Dickinson, obviously, is one of the most important American founders, overshadows his younger brother. But that doesn't mean that Philemon over here didn't do a great job during the American Revolution. So Philemon actually starts out as a regular old lawyer and farmer. And he's living in New Jersey, and then the Revolutionary War starts approaching, and hostilities with Great Britain start approaching, and since Philemon's brother John wrote many famous pamphlets promoting the rights of British citizens, well, Phil here took his brother's lead and also really became an early and active patriot. So when Lexington and Concord breaks out, Philemon joins the New Jersey Militia. Now, he's only appointed as a colonel, but he does such an excellent job during this time that he makes his way up all the way to major general in just a year and a half. And by 1777, he's in command of all of New Jersey's militia. Now, this basically keeps him within New Jersey. He's only commanding the troops within New Jersey, because once they leave New Jersey, then they're called levies and they're kind of under the command of the Continental Army, yada, yada, yada. That being said, New Jersey had the most battles of the Revolutionary War, and therefore, Phil over here was real busy. So Philemon is running around. He's most notable probably for his role in the Forage Wars, which was battles in the no man's land of New Jersey trying to get food to feed these soldiers. Through this time, a little event called the Conway Cabal breaks out. Now, the Conway Cabal is pretty famous. Many people were not happy with George Washington's performance. Some people tried to get Horatio Gates or someone else to take over as Commander-in-Chief of the Continental Army. And eventually, it falls apart, this little cabal. And Thomas Conway, who the cabal is named after, he gets challenged to a duel by John Cadwallader. And Cadwallader was a cousin of Dickinson's, and the reason I bring up this interesting event and kind of famous event in American history, well, Philemon Dickinson served as the second to John Cadwallader, and as the second, he helped organize all the details. And just side note, that duel ends with Cadwallader shooting Conway in the face and standing over his body and calling him a damn rascal. So, a lot of fun there. Now, as for Philemon, he serves throughout the entirety of the Revolutionary War as commander of the New Jersey Militia once he takes command. And then after the war ends, he actually is elected to the Continental Congress as a representative from Delaware. Yeah, he spent most of his life in New Jersey, but the Dickinson family owned quite a lot of property in Delaware, and they didn't care about residency. They cared about the property you owned. And therefore, Dickinson was sent to the Continental Congress for several years, representing Delaware, after which he returns to New Jersey and is very quickly elected to the New Jersey State Assembly. He was there for several years, and then he actually serves as vice president of New Jersey State Assembly. So he becomes one of the leaders of the state of New Jersey during the period where the Articles of Confederation are in charge, and therefore there is no federal government. And being vice president of the state senate for 2 years makes you one of the most powerful people in the nation of New Jersey, which is how they, the separate states, considered themselves. Interestingly enough, U.S. Senator William Patterson, a Constitutional Convention delegate, is elected governor of New Jersey, and someone needs to take his place. So old Phil Dickinson over here is actually sent to the United States Senate, where he spends 5 years. He kind of takes a back seat. He's not really one of the most outspoken present senators, but he is there, and he does his time during the Washington administration, and after that, he retires to his farm and his private life, his private law practice. And that is a brief overview of Philemon Dickinson, best known probably as John Dickinson's younger brother, but he should be known as New Jersey's commander of the militia throughout the Revolutionary War. Hope you learned something today. If you did, definitely hit like and subscribe. I talk about American Revolution all week long, different founder every morning. So hit like, subscribe, and I'll be back with another founder for you tomorrow.